We're here. Now tell me what this is all about.
As I told you on Vikan Space Dock, Tenebrae's last gruesome weapon. He sought immortality, but only his endless spite survives now. Like you, I was once his wrath. And like you, I learned of his true nature and plotted his downfall. For centuries. Ultimately, I saw what had to be done, and betrayed my empire in order to destroy its creator. That is how I came to fight alongside Kira.
We fought the Emperor's servants constantly for years. We even thought we'd beaten him alongside my master. Then Yavin 4 happened. And Valkorion.
I received guidance from an old ally. Instead of seeking out our enemy in his current shell, you, as it turns out. We sought a different target. Tenebrae hid his original body where no one could harm it. As long as that body remained in stasis, the galaxy's greatest evil could never truly be killed.
Unless we destroyed Tenebrae, the fight against Valkorion would never really be over.
Since Valkorion is gone, I assume you've succeeded.
We did. As we later learned, we destroyed his first body just as you purged the last vestige of his twisted spirit from your mind. That is when his final weapon was unleashed. A Sith ritual, carved into his very flesh, unleashed an ancient plague from every molecule of his decaying corpse.
We were both knocked out cold, comatose for more than a year. Satil Shan was the one who finally pulled us out of that nightmare. And started a new one.
Like you, Kira and I have both been vessels for a portion of Tenebrae's power. It acted as a sort of vaccine. But Satil had no such protection, nor did any of her followers. Within days, they were all laid low, trapped in a nightmarish slumber. In helping us, they unknowingly doomed themselves.
This ritual, what can you tell me about it?
Nothing. We lost consciousness even as we felt it taking shape. The infection is worsening. There is a darkness growing among the afflicted.
We can feel their minds connecting, communicating. We're afraid they might be merging somehow.
Merging into what? Another Valkorion? Is this plague bringing him back somehow?
It's too early to make that conclusion. Whatever it is. It is immensely dangerous. We must stop it.
How?
We loaded Satil and all of her followers onto a transport to keep them quarantined, along with a few med droids to tend to them. The transport is programmed to fly a random course through unsettled sectors of the Outer Rim, all weeks away from civilization. I can send a signal to alter the course, bring it to another empty system that's closer so that we can meet it in a shuttle.
We board the ship. And connect our minds with yours through the Force. Together, we will face this entity and purge it from existence. And if we cannot purge it, then we destroy the transport and hope we've ended the old monster's schemes forever.
Valkorion was in my mind for a long time. What if connecting with this entity makes it stronger instead of weaker?
It won't. That is why we tested you as we did. To make sure that no trace of him remained. You will not strengthen this entity. Only destroy it.
It's gonna take a while for the transport to come back into range.
Then we should stay here until it does. If you require any assistance in the meantime, don't hesitate to ask.
Not so fast. I'm not fighting the Republic or the Jedi, so if that's what you want, definitely hesitate to ask.
Ignore her. If necessary, I can slay enough of your enemies for both of us.
Ugh.
She grows on you. Eventually.
Commander, looks like our new friends from the Hand have just entered orbit. I'll get them cleared to land right away.
Lord Wrath, I am Darth Rivix. I believe the Empress told you to expect me.
You'll be the Hand's liaison to the rest of the Empire.
Precisely. Competition for the role was heated, as I'm sure you can imagine. I am proud to have stood above all others. I'll have my shuttle bring me to the surface directly. I always prefer speaking in person.
Face to face at last. Your hollow does you no justice, my friend.
I hope you've come for more than empty flattery.
Let's find out. Permit me to be direct. My duty as liaison is to facilitate your operations as best I can. My success is judged by your success. I will not profit from obstructing or undermining you. Much as I savor them, deception and manipulation are not among my objectives here. I will relate my Empress's desires to you and your accomplishments to her. Anything you require of the Empire's resources, I will obtain. I shall be your ally, your spokesman, and I hope your confidant. You have my vow on it.
I hope you can live up to your word. I don't take disappointment well.
Nor should you. The best deserves the best. Now, if I may impose upon you a bit more before we delve into official matters, I would love a tour of your base. The stories I've heard.
One of my people can show you around. Find me when you're ready to focus on our work.
As you wish. Your base is truly impressive. You must be very proud.
Are you ready to focus now?
Yes, let's. The destruction of the Meridian complex on Corellia continues to accelerate our war efforts. We've won decisive victories in the Bormir, Atrevis, and Anoat sectors. The Republic is reeling. Perfect conditions for the Hand to press the advantage.
Where does Ascena want us to strike first?
That will come in time. For now, let's focus on logistical concerns. We are solidifying supply lines and secure communications between Odessen and the rest of Imperial space. A full detachment of Imperial troops is already en route to serve at your command. Assault troops, security personnel, patrol ships, and so on. Now then, there is one other matter that needs your attention as we spin up the Hand's day-to-day operations. The troops selected to join the Hand are among the Empire's best, but given your extensive combat experience, I thought you might like to order additional training?
These soldiers will have much to prove if they're to serve me. Only those who can survive the most rigorous training and tests will be accepted.
As you wish. I believe that concludes our business for the day. Do you require anything else?
Any word on Darth Malgus? I haven't seen him since Corellia.
You are not alone in that. No one has seen him since the battle. It's all rather mysterious. Perhaps he was more badly injured than anyone knows. Or perhaps he's gone rogue again. But surely that's not possible.
I will not return. I will not return. I will not
return. Once again, your vital signs have elevated far beyond ideal values. I am concerned that these episodes pose a risk of permanent damage.
Then stop them.
I have already removed all physical modifications related to your loyalty assurance protocols. These hallucinations are the result of psychological manipulation. To correct such potent mental conditioning is beyond my program's scope of practice. Honestly, I am unaware of any technique capable of editing the pathways of your mind so extensively.
I have heard of one possibility. Set course for Dantooine.
Waited too long as it is. Something is wrong. I'm sure of it.
Smashing up the place isn't gonna solve anything. We'll find the ship. It's gonna be all right.
I take it there's no sign of the transport with Satil and her followers.
Nothing! It isn't responding to our signals. And we've already checked the next scheduled stop. No sign.
Which leaves just about 200 or 300 systems to search.
There must be another way!
Have you always been this, emotional?
All we can do is start searching from the ship's last known coordinates, which, for us, could take forever. So we get an expert. We'll send T7 out with an escort and all the probe droids we can find. They'll cover more ground and sort through sensor readings faster than we ever could. T7 works as astromech magic, crunches the probe data to pick up a trail, and we find our missing ship in a matter of days or weeks, instead of years.
I can't think of anyone better for the job.
That's everything settled then. As soon as we get coordinates, you'll be the first to know. Don't worry, your furniture's safe. It'll calm down in a bit.
You don't demand anything, Jakiya. Certainly not from him.
If you're risking your life out there, I'll demand what the clan requires.
What's going on?
It seems I'm a child in need of a parent.
You're Mandalore, the Avenger. You have responsibilities to all of us.
So you often tell me.
Who's this?
Jakiya Ordo, one of my best. He managed to avoid my notice for too long, but now I've put him to work. Though I'm having second thoughts.
I would gladly go back to being an unknown Great Mandalore. I prefer the talk of warriors to the endless jabbering of politics.
The curse of being skilled at both, you old rancor.
So you're the one. Not sure if I should call you commander.
Not necessary. The need for a commander is done.
Understood. I like to be clear on these things. Helps me get your measure. The fact is, Lord Wrath, I only know your reputation. I don't know you. It's my job to take a hard look at anyone this close to Mandalore. Had a lot of dealings with your kind, Sith. I'll never understand what drives you, but I respect your focus.
Do you always speak this plainly to Mandalore?
I speak my mind, that's all. She's had a dozen occasions to stick a knife in my ribs for insubordination, but I'm still here. Bootlickers are only good for licking boots.
So what happens now?
I've seen your face. Looked into your eyes. That's what I wanted.
Satisfied?
For now.
Good. I'm sure you have more important things to do.
Some clan grumbling to track down. More than the usual complaints. Raz and I will check into it. Jakiya out.
Raz?
His brother. They're a family of Mandalorians. Lost a sister a few years back.
Something wrong?
That's the first time he's mentioned a clan issue. He oversees a lot of the day-to-day details without a word.
Let Jakiya find out more. If he's one of your best, trust him to do his job.
You're right. It's hard to sit back. But he's better at rooting out trouble. He kept an assassin's knife out of my gut more than once. You're a leader. How would you deal with unrest in the ranks?
If a group has a problem, it's usually for a reason. Maybe they see something you don't.
We have more in common than I thought. Mandalorians must be allowed to speak out, to think for themselves, to be effective. Jakiya demands order. Everything working together as a whole. I understand, and it keeps it all running. But I don't work that way. Well, looks like I've got reports to review on escort missions we've been overseeing. Jakiya snuck them into the transmission. Sneaky Chakar.
I'll leave you to it.
Did you learn anything from the clans?
Nothing I haven't mentioned before. A lot of heated words. Some are saying Mandalorians are just glorified couriers.
Still unable to see past their next fight. All tactics and no strategy.
However restless you are in the position, Mandalore, you sound like a leader.
I sound angry. My blaster is still a better negotiator than I will ever be. What about the escort runs?
Silence. But only a fool would believe they haven't heard something.
What happened?
Some of the cargo ships we were looking after ran into trouble. Mostly scouts sniffing around. But one exchanged fire. We've been looking into it.
Jakiya.
Lord Wrath, we meet again. I've been keeping an eye on you.
And?
Mandalore was right to stand by your side.
I do what I can.
Modesty.
Tell me more about these cargo runs. Who would attack Mandalorian ships?
That's the real question. They're well-equipped, and they know our methods.
You need to get ahead of this. Everyone knows the Mandalorians are looking after some very valuable goods. Very tempting.
Agreed. But it's not common bandits or even an ambitious cartel. This feels different. Like they're testing our defenses. I know you object, Mandalore. But we must look closer to home.
I don't object. I just want to be sure. Would some of the clans really go that far?
I'm not ruling it out. Like I said, there were some heated words.
Like Shay said, we need to know more before we jump to conclusions.
I understand. But something is making my trigger finger itch. We should have clamped down harder on the clans when we had the chance. The wound has festered.
No, Mandalorians aren't droids. We're best when we don't have some restraining bolt on our neck, even if it costs us.
Agreed. You go too far, and you risk losing control.
And sometimes, too much freedom leads to chaos and destruction.
Enough. We gave our word to protect those shipments, and we will.
Understood, Mandalore. I'll see if I can draw the enemy out. Can't fight what we can't see. If I'm lucky, I'll make them mad enough to come out and play. Jakiya out.
I'd prefer a fight to all this sneaking about.
Agreed. Keep me informed.
Count on it.
Hey,